Giant blog post just released on the official Marvel Strike Force website, guys. Silver Surfer's release method is confirmed. Polaris is confirmed. Beast is coming formal. And we got the full kit for Multiple Man and a lot more, guys. And if you're ready to find out all about this blog post and what is upcoming in this next update, you know what to do. Find that like button and let's go smash it!
Alley Flyer.
Oh, hello, Valley Maniacs. I am Valley Flying. Welcome back to the Valley Flying channel. And we are discussing a lot of big news that just dropped on the official Marvel Strike Force website, their latest blog post, released every Friday. And we got the release method for Silver Surfer. It is not what I was expecting. Beast is becoming farmable. Polaris is confirmed. And we got the latest member of the X-Factors full kit, Multiple Man, just teased yesterday on social media with this picture, guys. And if this is your first time here, make sure you subscribe to the channel. It helps out the algorithm. Hit that like button, hit that notification bell as well, and share this with your friends if this video is helpful for you. But without further ado, boom, let's check out the blog post. Three times around the sun. All right, there's a stellar celebration coming. Silver Surfer joining the strike team soon. You can recruit him not just yet, but he is arriving through it. He's throwing an event of cosmic proportions, a stellar celebration, the 3-year anniversary of Marvel Strike Force. And this is something that they have not done. I don't even remember what they did in year one for their anniversary. Year two, I think they did some pretty good stuff. They brought back some events, things like that. And I think this may be the biggest anniversary that they have so far in Marvel Strike Force. So there's going to be these orbs, solar, galactic, celestial orbs. Makes your roster go supernova with a limited time cosmic essence currency, and the solar, galactic, and celestial orbs earn the cosmic essence via blitz battles, campaign nodes, and select daily objectives, then use his special currency to boost the events in the supply stores for purple, orange, and blue give rewards. So this seems like a very, like a normal type or a different type of event release character than we've had in the past, but very curious what these different orbs are going to do, what the rewards are, what is the best method to get the max amount of Silver Surfer shards. That's what the prize is for this, guys. Dark Matter Milestone: blast off by opening solar, galactic, and celestial orbs to earn character shards, gear, gold, training modules, and other resources. All this stuff sounds good so far, guys. Universal Truth Milestone: turn your war efforts into a milestone rocket fuel by spending war credits, elite war credits, to hit the milestones to earn cosmic essence. So save your currency, guys. Save it up for this event. You're gonna need it. So hoard your war currency, guys. Anniversary calendar and logging in 14 days for earning cosmic essence gold promotion credits. Yes, they didn't mention they were giving more of these, but I hopefully do more of these type of events where they're giving more silver, more gold promotion credits, because one of the big issues I had with the road ahead and their community feedback blog post, not mentioning Red Star. So if they're going to be doing more of these type of events and not just for this sort of anniversary, guys, maybe that's the solution that we need for Red Stars. I am not sure, but let me know what you're thinking of this Silver Surfer event so far. There's some bonus events as well. 2x the training modules from campaign events. 3x origin gear from campaign nodes. That's some good stuff. Geology bounty, 2x ISO 8 crystals. And when refreshing your campaign energy, earn 2x the amount. That is very good, especially if you're not level 80 yet. You're probably going to want to save some energy for this. All right, Multiple Man, the next big thing discussed. The latest member of the X-Factor pairing with the Dad Bros. And oh yeah, confirmed in this. Polaris is confirmed coming to Marvel Strike Force. So, Multiple Man, he is a member of the X-Factor team. Multiple Man is a unique protector. I wasn't sure what class he would be, but protector with the X-Factor tag. He has high health, high resistance, uses dupes to protect himself and his allies. Instead of using a classic taunt, Multiple Man's dupes will heal Multiple Man when they die and steal positive effects from enemies and spread them to Multiple Man. This looks like I like these kind of unique kits. I don't think we've seen a kit like this in Marvel Strike Force, definitely. And I don't think I've seen a kit like this previously. Let me know if you guys have in any previous games that you have played, though. Multiple Man's dupes heal Multiple Man the way they die. Oh, we read that. They spread them to him. And because taunt gets applied to the dupes, multiple men gains an advantage against characters who specialize in breaking down a single protector. That is good. That like Ultimus, I can think of him breaking down single protectors. So if you're breaking down dupes, you are protecting the dad bros, which is really what the purpose of multiple men is supposed to be, because they have some insane damage. And I cannot wait to see what the rest of this team looks like. Multiple man gains an advantage over characters that's... Oh, we're reading multiple things here, guys. He works best when paired with Polaris. So double synergy here, guys. We got the synergy with the dad bros, and it looks like we're going to have some synergy with Polaris and multiple man. And the rest of the X Factor, as multiple man's special, clears negative effects from himself. And if Polaris is an ally, his passive increases resistance for all X Factor allies. Man, if it was increasing the crit chance and crit damage for these guys, especially with the dad bros, this team would be insane. All right, find strength in numbers with multiple man hero City, which is interesting. I think this is the first City mutant that we've had. I may be wrong on that, but it's the first one that comes to my mind. Mutant Protector X Factor. I think most of them in global, and then we've had the two dad bros with that cosmic tag, but City is the interesting one here. His basic is 1-2 punch, attacking primary target, 320% damage. This attack gains 10% damage per dupe ally, so you can gain some pretty good damage here. All right, Helping Hand. Energy cost is 3 out of 3, so available on turn 1. He's going to summon 2 dupes. He's going to remove all negative effects from all dupe allies, applying Taunt and Death Proof to all dupe allies. And if Polaris is an ally, clear all negative effects from self, and he's going to gain immunity for 1 turn. So, interesting protector. Now, this next one is kind of weird. He has an energy cost of 6 out of 8, so not available on turn 1. You could use this on turn 2, but summoning 9 dupes, and this is very strange. Like, most of the time, you're not going to be summoning 9 dupes. There's only 10 characters available on the field at the same time, so you're going to have some waste, especially in the early turns, but maybe some of your characters get killed. You'll be able to summon more than the required... More than what you normally would, but 9. I mean, you're gonna have to be almost all dead for him to summon all 9 dupes. Applying offense up for 2 turns, unless there's some unique weird mechanic that they get stacked on top of each other or something like that. Applying offense up for 2, and that actually reminds me of the battle droid, the battle droid in Stawaga. So maybe there are some similarities with this kid. Applying offense up for 2 turns, 2 counters for X Factor and dupe allies, and filling speed bar by 30% for dupe allies. And we got the kiss for the dupe down here, guys. And passive is Madrox Prime Win, and enemy attacks multiple man, summon a dupe. He's gonna have a lot of dupes on the field, so unless they have some kind of stacking on top of each other so that they don't have that 10 character restriction, and a lot of stuff seems redundant unless they remove that restriction from multiple man. So I'm curious to see how this is going to play out in battle, guys. On death of an ally dupe, heal for 5% of this character's max health. On war offense, summon an additional dupe when multiple man is attacked, which is good. So this looks like a war offense-minded team. On spawn, he's going to summon 2 dupes. So dupes all around, guys. Just dupes. Gaining 30% resistance. Non-summoned X-Factor allies gaining 30% resistance as well. So nothing about crits, nothing about crit damage here, guys. So as strong as the dad bros are, it's not making them stronger. It's just protecting them to keep them on the field longer. The dupe, what is it going to do? Well, it's also going to have that Hero City Mutant Protector X-Factor tag. The basic is going to be attacking the primary target, 320% damage, copy and clearing 1 positive effect, excluding regeneration, so they're not healing themselves. You're going to spread all positive effects, excluding taunt regeneration to multiple man. So stealing buffs, guys. They're going to need some focus for this, and they're getting it with this 75% extra focus for the attack, but it cannot crit. I don't think the damage is the big thing here, guys. I think it's the buff stealing that these guys do. And his passive on spawn, applying counter to the multiple man that summoned this dupe. The multiple man that summoned this dupe. I guess that is there in case you get a bunch of multiple mans. You bring in a multiple man, you bring Sinister, you clone a multiple man from another team. And yes, so it's going to go just the one that summoned that dupe, and he's going to get some extra focus, or that dupe is going to get some extra focus as well. So interesting kit here. Let me know your thoughts on this kit here, guys, as we move on to the legendary rotation. And this is some good news. People have been wanting to know about this legendary rotation. And as the game has progressed and gotten bigger, the amount of legendary characters that we have in the game just expands, which means that these aren't returning as frequently as maybe Scopely and Foxnix wanted when they originally brought in this legendary system. So I like what they did here, guys. After 3 years of protecting Nexus, Earthstrike features an impressive amount of legendary characters. Yes, at this point, we're going to start running older legendary characters more often as an added bonus for increased accessibility. This is good. I think this is a good catch-up mechanic for newer players that don't have some of these characters. I wish they would have talked about this last week in the as sort of a catch-up mechanic, because that is one thing I feel is missing. Definitely need to go a little further with the catch-up mechanics. I'm not sure what else they're going to do, but I think this is a good start. But they probably knew they were going to do this. They should have mentioned this. This means that they could have had more one. This means that there could be more than one legendary event running simultaneously, and that could reoccur more often. That is good. So the rotation, it could be in flux if they're going to do this, which I guess is good for Scopely, because that incites that panic farming. But I guess it kind of is good for some players as well that need these legendary events. So stay on your toes with these schedules, guys. Bonus events that grant 2x charge for required characters on campaign nodes will still run for these legendary events, which is good. And again, this kind of addresses some catch-up mechanics. I wish they would have gone further with it, but good. However, instead of the daily login calendar 7 days that you normally see at the start of a legendary event, you'll receive an inbox message with a character charge required for the legendary. 5 characters, 3 charges each. So for some of these older events, we're technically getting less shards, but we're just getting them all at once in our inbox and not having to wait for the entirety of the event. I guess it may be inbox and then legendary event just pops up, and that's why, because there's not as much lead up time for these. We're doing this to minimize the calendar clutter with multiple legendary events and running to make the process more automated. I think this is a good thing. Step in the right direction, Scopely. I still get confused sometimes. We will keep you informed of when the future legendary events move into this increased reoccurring pattern, and thus when character shards move from the daily login calendar to be delivered through instead. Through inbox messages, the Invisible Woman will kick things off. Then now you see me. More legends adding soon, so look out for further additions. I think this is all positive, guys, that part of the legendary events, except for maybe not knowing a full rotation. That may be the only downside to this. All right, so Space Ace is coming back, so get your Guardians ready, Star-Lord. Especially with what we know about Silver Surfer's kit, maybe returning to relevance, because he is a cosmic hero, guys. All right, this is a big one for all you X-Men fans. Stars and Guard as Astonishing X-Men Support Specialist is on the move. You'll soon be able to find Beast in Nexus 5-6. Be sure to head there and get your fill of these character shards. Beast will replace Green Goblin, but if you're looking for his shards, the Mad Bomber, you can find them in Villains 2-3. So Green Goblin going to Villains 2-3. Beast going to Nexus 5-6. Normally, these do these on Wednesday. So we can expect to have these, or I am expecting to have these on Wednesday. March 17th is what I predict based on what they've done in the past. Upcoming blitzes, terrorize with the coming blitzes, and we've seen the full blitz schedule on the marvel.com earlier this week, guys, and this is holding in line with that. America Chavez, and then the big one, Scream. Yes, not Marvel Scream, and Scream also the battle pass season 4 character there. So yes, and hopefully they're bringing some changes to RTA, which was another major pain point for me. Hopefully some of these changes make RTA, or the changes that they described in last week's blog post, hopefully that makes that mode a little less painful. And yes, we could get all our Scream shards. Bonus and flash events, we got a bunch of them, guys. Women's History Month, as described in that blog post earlier on the marvel.com. Captain Marvel getting double drops. There's another character getting double drops as well. I can't remember it off the top of my head, but check out my tweet. Check out the video that we described that. And you can see that, but yes, more double drops coming. Prepare for the Invisible Woman Legendary, Double Trouble. You get Sinister 6 character shards, so doubling the event, and it looks like we're just going to get Sinister 6 shards in our inbox. 3 of each of the 5 characters. So I'm not sure how it's going to work with Sinister 6 when there's more than 5 Sinister 6 members. Neighborhood Watch is coming back, so you get your T4s, guys, next week. You got 2x City... City Hero Shard. So actually not next week. We're getting the double drop next week, probably on the 26th. Friday the 26th is when we could probably expect this block party. And for all the buffs out there, Payday is coming back, so double drops for the minions. So that is it for the blog post, guys. Lots of stuff there. I think this is a pretty positive blog post after some of the negative ones with this community feedback. I think things are starting to look up, guys, but let me know your thoughts. What are you most excited for? The Silver Surfer release method, Beast, finally becoming formidable after all this long. Are you excited for Multiple Man and his role on this X Factor team? Or is it that Polaris was confirmed as the next X Factor character? Or anything else in this blog post, guys? Hopefully you enjoy this. Share this with your friends, and I will see you next time. Give me a Hulk fist bump before you go. Check me out on social media. Check out some of the sponsors down below as well. There's a lot of great companies that support this channel. And I will see you guys next time. Hulk fist bump, Valley Flying out. Have a great weekend, guys.